Alright, let's see if we can sneak in a quick hour video. How are we looking? Level 109? Damn. We're just shooting for level 90, 101, I think, right? 97, then I said actually, it turns out there's something else that actually makes a big difference at 101. Now we're level way beyond that. Okay then. And I actually can. Nice. I do have shotguns in this game. And that part, best parts that we have. Made all the shotgun ammo we can. How are we doing on food and water? Could use some more food and some more water. Should also plant this corn, frankly. That'll be our infinite source of food with cornbread later on. Keep those anvils strapping. I know we have an iron thing downstairs, but I don't want to have to take the time to go fiddle with that too much. And we need these seeds. And we need 4 wood, I think, to make a hoe. Doesn't it automatically just move it up? Seriously. Oh hey, we're already at full 600 quality. That's right, we spammed out the anvils, and I was very good with my anvil prediction, as I recall. So where do we want to put a farm? Eventually we may do so underground, or on top of the roof for a little bit, but right now, I'm not quite wanting to do that. I am apparently wanting to miss. I have no idea what the deer is, okay. What the hell? So that went over, the others went under. On my game today. Alright, maybe up here if there's some flat land. About it. We'll set up a better farm later on. Fun fact about hoes, if you're not aware, then we'll refrain from any kind of sexual innuendo, please. If you try to hoe next to a row you've already hoed, bam, it destroys it. It goes one out in each direction, so you need to move 2 over, and then you can till rows. And if this was a more permanent farm, we'd even be placing down wood frames or other frames to flatten land to make it easier to work with. But it's not, so I'm not too concerned. Apparently, hoes used to be very good at destroying grass, and you could rapidly do it, but clearly, they kinda don't. That. I guess we can take the hoe with us and just destroy it if necessary. We'll go with that, I guess. Back to its village. Theoretically, if we were being super optimal, we could be trying to grind all the way up to, like, level 129, I think, the next breakpoint, but especially for a beginner's video, I really don't want to be doing that. You certainly don't need it. At this point, level 97, you'll easily get enough items to be doing fine. How's our weaponsmithing? 95. So we could technically make a slightly better bow, I believe. I'm not too worried about it. And we have 64 points available. We have 3 out of 5 boomstick, good. 3 out of 5 pistols, good. You know what? We're going for it. I'm not even sure what the point of this is, frankly. Dismember, whatever. Again, I don't know. Maybe it means that if one piece of shrapnel hits their head, it manages to have a chance to instantly destroy it and one-hit kill. The best explanation I'm coming up with offhand, but I'd rather just do more damage with accurate shots and, you know, kill them in the first place. So, I also need to start marking on the map which places I've looted. Overall, though, my endgame goal is to be using a Magnum plus. Have we looted all of this place? Yeah. I seem to recall that there was a place that we did not get to loot the upper story of. Or maybe it was basement of. Let's grab that. Maybe it was this place in some way? Really not sure. This seems untouched entirely. So maybe I need to be going back. Hunting knife book. Nice. Of course we need to hit weaponsmithing 100, so we need to grind that out. Those look like brass, and not so iron. Yeah, iron. Oh well. Brass would have been nice. But tis was not to be, or whatever. I ain't an English major, okay? I talk good. Come to think of it, I'm not a major anything at this point. Well, actually, some people think of me, man, a major jerk. A major arrogant jerk or something. Maybe it was this place back here that we didn't get the basement of, or roof of, something like that. Is this brass? It's brass! It's brass! If we looted that, we have. This is the problem with not marking on your map properly as I meant to do. Some of you watch it like maybe you're a major clueless head or something. Can't remember what he's done. Okay, so we definitely got that house and we got this house. We'll see. You know what I think might have happened now that I'm trying to recall? I think we had that whole horde come through, didn't we? As like, you know, it's not worth taking the time to fight them, so we're just gonna go ahead and move on down to the south instead. I think we need more gunpowder. Like I said, don't be afraid of trying to just line up your shots like that and make them count. Unless it's versus a pig, in which case you should wildly spam some shots as quickly as you can. And keep cursing when you miss. That's the best strategy for pigs. The downstairs for this place that we didn't get, perhaps. I'm a wizard, see? I just knew that. Instantly, no hesitation. No incorrect guesses, and I'm going to delete the previous few minutes of this video to bear out my story. As far as you're concerned, I just can't. Got it? Stuff right now. Oops. Assemblage from the shotgun. Hunting rifle I can assemble. Pistol I cannot. Now, an important thing. Reload. Whenever you adjust it like that, it unloads the ammunition. You don't want to then be in a firefight and be like, shit, let's grab a shotgun, then be like, shit, it's not loaded, shit. Ah, I'm dead now. If only I'd listened to Balkoth when he said to remember to reload after adjusting the weapon. Just saying, you don't want those to be your final thoughts. One of the things I hate about the bow is trying to adjust each game, because it's like completely awfully awful range initially, and then as you get higher quality the range becomes significantly better, so you keep having to constantly adjust to it. Then you start a new game and you're back to square one with shitty awful bows. Then you're overheating. Because you have 10% insulation from that for some reason. Well, that was because of the rain, I think, wasn't it? Yeah. Need more iron armor things before we do that. Probably just use a plant fiber chest overall. I think it offers better protection, but less insulation. As you can see, I'm like only really caring about the brass here. Why? Because the rest of it I can produce very easily, or I have tons of already. Wait, what? I have never seen that before. House slash poppin' pills combination or something? That's different. The glue is something I will cheerfully throw out eventually. We all know that eating as many vitamins as you can increases your wellness, right? If your doctor says there's a limit on what vitamins can do, he's just trying to hurt you. Probably kill you. Get him first. No, I actually don't. Doctors are generally very selfless people, dedicating their lives to helping others, and we should be grateful for what they do. This message has been brought to you by Doctors Anonymous America, which I am not one. I'm weirded out over this thing. I don't know if we have another one of those. I don't even really care about those. But is that two science there? Four! Four science, damn! Alright, it's only too high. Oops. I thought there was a safe here. So we do know iron helmets. We're not using them. So, we don't know gloves or boots, okay. I think I was trying to not skill up anymore. I don't remember at this point. Reasons. But this is like, see, this is the front of the store right here. This would only be the front. Then you come into the back area here. So, and then there's no door out of here in the back. So explain this to me. You approach the poppin' pills from the side that's not a poppin' pills, and looks like you can't tell that. And you pull up to the drive-thru, I guess, and get your medicine handed you from bars while you look in at the family's home who runs the poppin' pills? If anyone's interested in shedding some light on this, I would be very curious about it. This is weird. It's just, it's like they were just mashed together with no sense of propriety or anything. Another hunting rifle schematic. 600 pistol parts, 540 shotgun parts. I think I'd prefer to take that over 9 wood for sure. Keep the aviator goggles because we might be in situations where we don't want the extra insulation from the shades. So, like, hi guys, how you doing? Come to our shop. It's right over there. Pull up at the window like that car did. We'll give you your medicine, even though we're open to the zombie infection through our house, or We are just going to pretend that never happened and move on. How about that? Also, something you might find interesting. Again, do this at your own discretion. If you're wondering why was it moving so slowly, well, shotguns have this 80% chance to apply a winded effect. So does the blunderbuss, technically, which is one of the shotguns. Fully looted the cracker book. We will double check. Iron. Okay. And by downstairs, I mean the non-existing downstairs, obviously. Glue is an earlier stage than duct tape, so we'll get rid of that. Seriously, what the hell? That is like an unholy union or something. Also, one of the few good things about the pistol, you can theoretically do stuff like this. Stealth headshot will take most of the weak zombies out without causing too much noise from a greater distance and speed than you can with a bow. Of course, you could just do the same thing with like a magnum headshot or hunting rifle headshot or whatever. So, once you have the calipers, it's not nearly as potentially valuable, but... Duke's Casino tokens. We don't care about your leatherworking stuff. Space. Which I should have thought of sooner. I think I did see a working stiffs that I'd like to lose. If we skin something else, I'll make up my mind enough to drop. I think that might have been a working stiffs. And we'll mark. These places as looted. Ideally we zoom in more on the map for this. And you get this awkward thing of having to scroll up. I don't remember how far my tunnel over in this direction got. Is this working stiffs? It is! I'll leave that there. I don't expect to ever care about it, but should the unforeseen happen, I can at least leave it around. Tore through this place. Really. We can make more duct tape. Like, I find the sledgehammer not really useful, frankly. But for the sake of this video, I'll bring it along. And by bring it along, I mean arg. By bring it along, I mean I'll just leave it there for now. Because I can't justify bringing back over anything else really right now that I can think of. Well, we don't need to come back for that oil anyway. It's better to come back and rather than destroy some of this stuff. I do want to keep some medical supplies. I personally don't think I will ever need them, but I don't want to be encouraging new players to just not bother with medical supplies, you know? There are calipers. This is one of the benefits to wait until that level 101 bit. So we can leave the basic first aid bandages here. There's a small engine we can grab and use as well. And that calipers is huge. But again, I think looking through some of the code, the XML file, and assuming I'm interpreting it correctly, which is a bit trickier because it's not actual code, which would be easier to interpret. Looks like being like level 101 makes a big difference. We can't make wrenches yet, can we? Nope. So we'll leave behind some bones. And then we need to leave about an hour to get back to base, so we'll leave shortly after this just to be on the safe side. Gas can schematic. Nice. That I am actually quite happy about. That will allow us to level our science. It'd be fun if we found a second calipers, but alas, just not to be. Our inventory's full enough that we'll just cut our scavenging today short and head back to base. I'm probably going to set up a little chest or three in town that I can bring supplies to. Inventory fills up, throw it in the stash. Because the problem right now is that, say, I don't know, say 6 or 7 slots, if you will, are always going to be filled with things like some medical supplies or bronze or brass trophies of various types. So you come, let's say that you have 20 slots free and then another 7 of those filled, right? So you come here and you get 27 slots to fill and you run all the way back. Then you run all the way back to the town, fill 27 slots, and go back and forth, blah, blah, blah. Problem, what if you just kept throwing the brass into, like, a supply chest instead? Well, you then could fill up those 7 slots with something else. And if those kept being brass, you could again throw them into the chest. You see where I'm going with this? Because you are keep transporting those brass, and they will stack with each other, by having to try to have the stacks, you will save a lot of travel time when you do eventually go back to base. It's only things like gun parts or schematics, unique schematics, that, you know, you ultimately have to take the distance to transport them or not. But I could loot the, you know, the rest of the town, and as long as I found nothing but the brass stuff, I wouldn't have any inventory problems, because I already have, like, one of each brass type. And I don't want to scrap it, because then I lose 25% of it. Or more, because of how the formula works. So you can see, we're easily back to base with quite a bit of extra time. We do have an exploding crossbow bolt schematic. Let's give a moment of, like, you know, angelic chorus. Ah, calipers. Some are going to say I was incredibly lucky finding them on the first working disc. I don't necessarily disagree. However, I would point out that I specifically waited until I was over level 101, which, if I read the XML correctly, I think triples my chance or something compared to being level, like, 1 to 50 and still a 50% improvement over, like, 50 to 100, something like that. I'd have to double check. Shotgun stuff here. Those are so bad quality compared to the 430, I'm not even going to bother keeping them at this point. This I will keep because it's at nearly 300 at least, and I might want it for different types. I doubt I will ever use those, but worst case, it might be something to play around with later on, you know? But we could get a very high-quality pistol if we managed to find the book. Now, couldn't we? Magnum, we just need the frame for. And, I presume, the book. Yeah, we need the book, too. That is still health stuff, isn't it? Ammunition. So the order of tonight is probably going to be get weaponsmithing up to 100. Is that a deer or something? I think that's a deer. That was a deer. So we're going to do something a bit crazy here. We have 5 minutes before it disappears. So we are going to turn off our forges. Why? Because if a screamer is going to come along, we want to make sure she's not going to surprise us. So we're giving her a little bit of time. Then we are going to keep working on scrapping anvils. So we still have several of those to scrap. But once these are done, we worry about some other things. And we have there. All those are empty. Cool. Should be more than sufficient. Throw a little bit of iron there. I need to save up some upcoming points to learn some of this other stuff, don't we? Rationale here being that if a screamer is going to show up, basically she would have shown up by now. If a wandering horde, could theoretically come along right in that 10-second window or whatever, but the odds are very much against that. But it couldn't. Oh, and now that we have calipers, we can make steel arrowheads, actually. Which, incidentally, are much better for raising up weaponsmithing skill than even, I think, the clubs would have been. Why? Because they take... Because iron arrowheads are roughly equal to the... So let's see, and if you were going to make 100 iron arrowheads, it would take 20 seconds, it says. If you wanted to make 100 steel arrowheads, it'll... It will take longer. So it looks like it's basically the same XP per time either way. But on the flip side, there is another side benefit to this. See, with the steel arrowheads, those are the best arrowheads we're ever going to get, right? Now you might be thinking, okay, but does that really justify making like 750 steel arrows? No, you're absolutely correct. But it does justify making 750 steel crossbow bolts. Yeah? That is the beauty of it. Because we are going to use those steel crossbow bolts once we get a crossbow. And we will need to make these bolts eventually, so we're making the best type of ammunition possible, in effect. Probably going to stop this at about 150. So I can check on the time remaining for a minute left on the anvil stuff. Take off that. Take off that. Fetch the brass. And the arrows that are necessary. And the wood that is necessary. So we want another 600. Thank you. Okay, if you didn't remember, day 19, so we should probably hear a dog attack sometime in the very near future. We're gonna stop this at 400 left because we're done with the crossbow bolts, so we want to queue more up. It's a nice easy number to remember. Except if I click, it'll mess something up, so I can't actually click on anything. I'm gonna stop this at about 200. Actually, I lied, I'm gonna stop it at 225. Since we are out again. Something you should optimize. I'm not optimizing it because A, I'm trying to, restrict myself and not get too far ahead of other people, and B, because I'm lazy. And B is definitely not the prime factor there in this case. It is totally the other one. Absolutely. 100%. Smithing, we are easily going to hit 600. So let's get that hunting knife handy. We will need 2 forged iron. It'd be really embarrassing if I was wrong about hitting it. How are the other forges looking? You need a refill, and you are not even on. Whoops! No one saw that. Where is 100 weaponsmithing? I feel like this is Spaceballs. Did you see what I was doing here? No, sir, I didn't see you playing with your dolls again. Good. I think it's called a suspiciously specific denial. No, officer, I have no idea why you're asking about what I was doing on March 18th at 5:30 p.m. at this at that address. It's like, then how did you know that's exactly what I was going to ask you or something? So now the question is, how close were we? Ones that I haven't hit that I want to be hitting. Weaponsmithing is maxed. Toolsmithing is maxed. Tailoring will raise eventually, I guess. Miscellaneous maxed. Mining tools maxed. Gunsmithing maxed. Construction tools will max over time. We can always brute force it with wood frames if we really want to. But I'm not trying to push for the level 129 mark for these videos. Don't want to bore people that much. Is this as far as we came? I suppose so. That doesn't continue, obviously, right? It's just mining stuff. So, I feel like I should really have something in my crafting queue, though, right now. I shouldn't be too about this. I'm nerfing myself, because I don't think we actually have a bunch of plant fibers stored up or anything to work on tailoring. Two options as we get closer to the town. A, we start angling up and we build a sort of ramp to the surface. Or B, we set up something similar with a ladder and hay bale. I am very much tempted to say the ladder and hay bale. One, it gives us more construction tool skill. Two, it allows us to more quickly enter and exit our tunnel. We can just hop, you know, down. Or just climb up, you know, saves time there. In other words, we invest a bit more time setting it up, but hopefully that winds up paying off longer term. Powder. I mean, if we ever need more gunpowder, we'll treat that as a very serious question after having created how many thousands? Well, it's possible we may, like on day, I don't know, 30, 40, not the, fucking no way day by day 30, I don't know, 40 plus if we go crazy with the gunplay. So we're, I don't know, 30% of the way there or something. We're actually putting a good solid night's worth of mining away here. Pretty sure we can make it nearly the rest of the way. And remember, one of the benefits of this, right, is the ability to be taking the tunnel during the night if you want, and then pop out where you want, basically at dawn. And conversely, you don't have to enter the tunnel until it's actually night. We should start heading back. I'm not even sure we're going to make it there by dawn, per se. Alright, Dawn.